All right, I need to tap this hole. I want the hole to be perpendicular to the surface of the work. So that means that the tap needs to go in nice and vertical. Is it straight? How's that look? Is it straight? Oh, it's got to go this way. Okay. Is it straight? Nope, that's not right. Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video. I shot some footage of tapping holes for my power feed project for my mill. And after putting that video together, I realized that the technique I used to tap the holes probably was worthy of its own video. So I decided to create a standalone video with that section out of my power feed video, showing you exactly what I was doing. Now, most of us probably know the technique you see before you, where you use a drill press to line everything up and get a nice square tap into a hole. And then it's the normal process of working the tap back and forth to tap the hole. Of course, this would be a whole lot easier had I actually clamped this piece down. And if I was legitimately tapping that, I totally would have done that. But what do we do if we have a piece that we cannot fit into the drill press or the mill? How do we tap it, and how do we get a nice vertical engagement from the tap? That's where this technique shines.
So let's take a look back at the clip from the previous video on how to use a square tap.
I want to share with you a little creation that I have that I refer to as a square tap. It's this right here. It's just simply a nut of the correct size welded to a flat piece of steel. This gets mounted right over the top of the hole, and it allows me to make a tap that is square in both directions. It's perfectly vertical. It also gives me starter threads, which make it a whole lot easier to make my cuts. So here's how you use a square tap. You start by taking the tool and inserting a tap. You want it to go through to the point where it comes out the other side. Then with it sticking out the other side, you apply it to the hole. As you can see, it's not sitting level. So you back it off until it sits level. Once it sits level, you can tighten it up just a little bit and grab something to lock it in place. Once it's in place, I like to unscrew the tap and add a little cutting fluid. All right, cutting the threads is pretty simple. A little bit forward, a little bit backwards. A little bit forward, a little bit backwards. The premise here is we are cutting a thread, and then we're cleaning the thread with the backwards motion. So that little barb of metal that we've cut with the tap is getting removed when you go the other direction. So we continue working our way around until we get the hole tapped all the way through. Using this back and forth technique helps a couple of things. One, it makes cleaner threads. You don't end up breaking off threads inside the hole. It also makes it less likely that the tap will stick. So as long as you don't stick the tap, then you have a much reduced risk of breaking the tap. Once the tap's removed, ding, you remove the pliers and you have a nicely tapped hole. If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.
Then...